safe and comfortable flight for you. Our flying time is 4 hours today. We'll be serving breakfast. Please direct your attention this time to the video screens. We'll be showing you the safety features for the Boeing 767 aircraft. And then once the video has concluded, flight attendants will be in the aisle to answer any questions that you may have concerning the video. We thank you for your attention, and once again, welcome aboard.
Come on, fly with me. We'll float down in the blue. Once I get you up there, where the air is rarefied, we'll just glide. Once I get you up there, I'll be holding you so near, you might hear all the angels cheer because we're together.
Oh, thank Wilbur. Wilbur.
We'd like to welcome you to Los Angeles.
Hey.
Local time is now 10:40. It will take us a few minutes to taxi to the gate. Please remember to remain seated with your seatbelt fastened and with all of your luggage stowed until the captain has brought the jet to a complete final stop at the gate and turned off the fastened seatbelt light. That will be your indication that you'll be free to move into the aisles to collect the things you brought on board with you. Please remember again to use extreme caution when retrieving articles from the overhead bins. If you need assistance with connections here or ground transportation, or you need any other information, there will be a Delta agent greeting our flight as you enter the gatehouse. It's been a pleasure bringing you to Los Angeles today, and we look forward to seeing you on another Delta flight in the near future. Thank you, and have a pleasant stay here, or to wherever your destination is today. Thank you.
It is only natural that one of the most expensive shopping areas in the world is also located here. At its heart is the chic Rodeo Drive, a surprisingly short street packed with exclusive boutiques, designer names, and elegant places to eat.
Of course, we ate at one of the charming little cafes, the Cafe Trusla, right on Rodeo Drive.
And part Main Street, USA. You can stroll down world-famous Rodeo Drive and find a $2 million diamond at Cartier's, or pop into Walter's Coffee Shop for a $3 egg salad sandwich.
This is really two cities. There's the flashy, glamorous Beverly Hills, and the one where even though you have tons of money and maybe you're very famous, you want to have what we call a low-profile meal. We might all be in jeans, having a chopped salad at La Scala, a meatloaf sandwich at the Brighton Cafe. Those are little places that people don't really realize. We're there.
With a reputation as the world's ultimate business address, Beverly Hills has a lot to live up to. In 1994, shoppers dropped more than $40 million in its prestigious Golden Triangle area, which is home to more than 300 boutiques and the world's most fashionable department stores. The relationship between Two Rodeo, a quaint cobblestone walkway lined with the finest names in retail, is home to internationally renowned Tiffany & Company, which recently celebrated its 25-year affiliation with jewelry designer Paloma Picasso.
That's become kind of my emblem now, and I use it also in my accessories. I also then, you know, take them on to create necklaces, mix them with stones, diamonds.
One thing you'll need if you plan to visit Two Rodeo is plastic, and lots of it. That's exactly what actress Jasmine Guy had on hand when she took a very present.
Gigi. This is the Fred Heyman.
Hi. Fred Heyman.
Hey, I love your stuff. You. Bye, thank you.
They delight in fighting duels. But I prefer a man who lives and gives expensive jewels. Are a girl's best friend. A kiss may be grand, but it won't pay the rental on your humble flat. Or help you at the automat. Men grow cold as girls grow old, and we all lose our charms in the end.
But
square cut or pear shape. These rocks don't lose their shape. Diamonds are a girl's best friend. I've heard of affairs that are strictly platonic, but diamonds are a girl's best friend. And I think affairs that you must keep Masonic are the better.
Up your bag so I can see it and I can zoom in on the Louis Vuitton part. Louis Vuitton. And smile now with your Gucci and your, or no, your Giorgio thing here.
I'm a shopper.
Younger people who are now running Hollywood can afford to buy the homes in the flats. And those homes now are go from about $1.2 million to maybe $2 or $3 million tops.
And sprinkled among Beverly Hills' stately homes are some of the city's most talked about landmarks. There's the Witch's House, with its distinctive pitched roof and storybook wooden bridge. The 85-room graystone mansion is a testament to the excess of the Beverly Hills' early elite. And who could pass by Hugh Hefner's Playboy Mansion, the party stop for the world's most beautiful people?
People like to see the residence and the houses where the stars lived or where they live. I mean, it goes all the way through from periods of, you know, Douglas Fairbanks and then, of course, like Jack Benny and Lucille Ball. They lived next door to each other. Jimmy Stewart lived up in that area. In fact, still lives up there. He has two lots. He's got this house and then he bought a lot next door, which he has his beautiful garden there.
Is the newly renovated Beverly Hills Hotel. For more than eight decades, the Pink Palace has stood sentry at the top of Rodeo Drive.
One thing I really would like to do is I would love to live at this hotel. I think it's just the greatest place in the world to live. I mean, can you think of anything better to be met at the door, brought into the hotel, go to your bungalow, go down to the tennis court, go to the swimming pool, have breakfast here, have lunch, and retire? I mean, they could bury me there in Bungalow 5. It's perfect.
Built for an astounding $500,000 in 1912, this 12-acre urban resort has developed a reputation as a home to Hollywood's royalty.
Elizabeth Taylor's had many husbands here. Howard Hughes has had many mistresses here. There's been affairs, divorces, marriages, murders, all kinds of things.
At center stage is the hotel's internationally renowned Polo Lounge, the birthplace for countless movie deals and Hollywood romances.
No, I can't share that adventure with you.
It's such a wonderful place to meet friends. You can tell that there are an awful lot of people that have a great number of memories.
It's really kind of like a great fantasy place. It's very sexy. It's very romantic. I've got a lot of good memories here.
Next, it was on to the world-famous Smokehouse Restaurant across from NBC.
Ready? Hi.
To the Smokehouse and Sweetie.
Sweet.
California dreaming.
I'm sorry.
All right. What are we here?
Oh. Well, after a long day of shopping on Rodeo Drive, things such as a new Louis Vuitton bag, even though the one that I have is not totally worn out. Sweeties like me, we like to relax with a glass of red wine.
Yes.
And cheese garlic bread.
Oh, no, let's take a look at the cheese garlic bread. World famous.
Smokehouse
Restaurant. There we go, hon. Smokehouse.
Melrose Avenue in Hollywood.
You're at the Hollywood, the Valley Week Hollywood, where any shop girl could be a cop girl with just a good looking head.
You're at the Hollywood, that's the way Valley Hooly Hollywood. Where any office boy or young mechanic can be a panic with just a good-looking pan.
And any shop girl can be a top girl if she pleases the tired businessman.
Hooray for Hollywood! You may be homely in your neighborhood.
Be an actor, see Mr. Factor, you make your kisser look good. Another Papa Dion, your name is Neon. If you get lucky, you go. Yes, buddy, you'll arrive if you can top this five. Hooray for Hollywood.
Say, step in them.
Oh, no, but there are too many people.
Forget the people. Step in them. Wow, they fit like they were made for you.
Say, do you suppose that could be a lucky omen?
Why not? I'm not superstitious, but I could tell there was something, well, above the average about you. You know, same as there is about me. Where she is making her footprints. On reaching stardom in her first picture, The Little Corporal, she now takes her place among the other great luminaries of the screen.
Allow me to congratulate you, Miss Sears.
Thank you, Mr. Grauman.
And may your success, like the imprints you've just made, last forever.
Oh, thank you. Thank you very much.
And now, if you will, please. All right.
Now, Miss Sears will sign her name in the cement, and the ceremony will be complete.